Good morning. Will you please join me in prayer? Gracious God, we thank you for this day, and we invite your presence into this place as we've come together to celebrate the accomplishments of our graduates. We ask your blessing upon them, and may each graduate know your presence in their lives and understand how to use their abilities for your glory and kingdom. We pray you will give them purpose and direction as they enter the next phase of their lives. Lord, we ask your blessings upon the families, friends, and the William Carey University administration, faculty, and staff. Lord, help us to exemplify your love in our actions and words, and may this celebration be a reflection of the blessings that we find in knowing and loving you. Amen.
Please join me in the pledge to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. I would like to extend a very special welcome to you in the first face-to-face commencement in well over a year. I'd also like to introduce the platform party. To my right is Daniel Caldwell is the faculty marshal. Dr. Lisa Weaver, Doc is the chair of the PhD committee. Dr. Gary Breland is the provost of the university. Dr. Ben Burnett is the academic vice president. Dr. Teresa Poole is the dean of the School of Education. And Dr. Barry Morris is also chair of many of these. I also want to introduce a special guest a little further back, Dr. Aubrey Lucas, president emeritus of the University of Southern Mississippi, has served on the doctoral committee for one of these graduates and will help to hood that graduate in just a few minutes. I have to congratulate these graduates. They have worked through unusual difficulties to reach this stage in their career. And we commend them for sticking to their goal and reaching this point. Also, we commend their family and friends who have made sacrifices and have supported them during this time. I also want to say a special welcome and a word of commendation to the faculty who is here today, who have also worked under trying conditions to see that these students were able to progress to this point in their career. Now, as we debated who would be our graduation speaker, my argument is always that Abraham Lincoln gave the most famous speech in all of American history, and it took a little less than 3 minutes for him to make it. That was quite a contrast to Senator Douglas, who was actually the featured speaker at Hattiesburg. And he spoke 3 hours and 40 minutes. Nobody remembers a word that Senator Douglas said, but practically every school child can quote Abraham Lincoln's famous Hattiesburg address. So I am the speaker today. And I promise you to keep it within the limits that Abraham Lincoln set. But I want to give one last challenge to these graduates as they go out. They have demonstrated great endurance, wise decision-making, and I want to point to them a verse in the third chapter of 1 Kings. God appeared to King Solomon and offered him a wish. Now, how would you feel if God, the God of the universe, said, I'll give you just one wish? How would you feel about that? Well, King Solomon didn't make a snap on the spur decision. And that's the first bit of advice I want to give to these candidates. Whenever you're confronted with a question or a decision to be made, don't make snap decisions, but follow the example of Solomon. When God appeared to Solomon and said, I'll give you one wish, King Solomon paused. And the scripture says he first looked back. We can always gain much from the perspective of history. We don't have to always follow past precedents, but we should know why we are challenging them. And we should consider that precedents that have endured for centuries are worth our consideration today. So before you make a decision, do a little backward look to see how others have made similar decisions. And then the second thing was that he looked around to gain a sociological perspective. How do other people feel about this issue? What decisions are other people making? Again, not that others will dictate your decision, but your decision will be a stronger one if you consider how your friends and fellow have made decisions regarding the issue. So he looked back, he looked around, and then the scripture says he looked inward. Inward. You know, if we have been raised correctly, and most of you graduates have, in the strong Judeo-Christian principles or similar principles of other religious bodies, we have had instilled in us valuable traits that will be important to us as we make decisions. So ask yourself from within, what would it mean to me and those I love? So he looked back. He looked around. He looked within. And then finally, he looked up to the God who had made him and asked for guidance from God. And then, you know what King Solomon asked for? Think about this. The man reputed to be the wisest man in the world, when he was given a wish, he asked for wisdom, knowing that we never have it all, we never have enough, and we should continue the quest for wisdom, which is different from knowledge. It is founded upon and built upon knowledge, but it's a higher level than knowledge. And throughout the rest of our lives, dear graduates, we should continue to seek for wisdom as we make decisions and as we live our lives.
Thank you, Dr. King, for that challenge to our graduates. And I welcome you, our guests, to this commencement ceremony. We're glad that you could be here to witness the conferral of degrees to these candidates. In this ceremony, we are awarding doctoral degrees to students in education. These women and men are professional educators in positions of leadership and are highly motivated to improve the education of students in the school districts where they serve. We consider it a privilege to join with them in their professional development and preparation for making a difference in their communities. Dr. Ben Burnett, Executive Vice President and former Dean of the School of Education, will be greeting the candidates at mid-stage and give them their diploma covers. Dr. Lisa Weaver and Dr. Willie Pierce will be hooding the candidates. And after the candidates have been presented, I will call on you to recognize them as a group. Dr. King, upon the recommendation of the faculty, I present these candidates to you for the conferral of their degrees.
By the authority of the Board of Trustees of William Carey University, I hereby confer upon you the degrees which you have earned, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities that throughout our world pertain thereunto.
Thank you. Will the candidates please rise and come forward in order? Sheila Nicholson Anthony. Lauren Ishii Bailey, Doctor of Education. Lee O. Bellin, Doctor of Education. Samantha Davis Benson, Doctor of Education. Ashley Marie Bowen, Doctor of Education. Shara Sharice Conway, Doctor of Education. Miska L. Davis, Doctor of Education. Alfreda Marie Dido, Doctor of Education. Deanna Mackey Gardner, Doctor of Education. Letitia Michelle Hunt, Doctor of Education. Shalonda D. Kirksey, Doctor of Education. Amanda Faith Provine, Doctor of Education. DeAndra Nikita Steele, Doctor of Education.
Go DeAndra, I want DeAndra Steele. Hallelujah.
Jermaine Taylor, Doctor of Education. Victoria Lynn Young, Doctor of Education, and her hooding will be assisted by Dr. Aubrey Lucas. Julia Elaine Adams, Doctor of Philosophy. Tykeria Burt, Doctor of Philosophy. These are the School of Education doctoral graduates of May 2021. Help me congratulate them. At this time, I ask that you stand for the benediction, and then please remain in place while the graduates recess. Following the recessional, ushers will direct you to file out row by row. Please proceed out of the building without congregating in the lobby or outside the exits.
Let me add my word of welcome, but also my word of congratulations as former Dean of Education and also the committee chair for some of the people on the stage. What a great honor. So it's now my pleasure and privilege to close us out by going to our God and Creator in prayer. So join me as we pray. Most gracious Lord, we thank you for your love for us today, and we thank you for the candidates on the stage. And also, we're grateful and show appreciation to the families represented not only here, but countless supporters and family members that have made today possible for these graduates. We thank you that these graduates specifically have answered your call to lead in the field of education, to help others pursue their dreams and their call. We pray for them in the coming days, for the many trials that they will face as leaders, and pray that for your strength. And again, we are grateful for their presence here and grateful for the existence of William Carey University, and we pray for our Christian higher education institution as we continue our mission to serve you. In Jesus' name, amen.